Hey YouTube, Sweet Knives here. Thanks for checking out another video. We got a cool knife sent in to the channel to review. It's one I recently did an old style of it. It's called the Mini Reflex 2. It's the 2551 BK. Guys, hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel. We're going over Sweet Knives, and that's as simple as it is. Sweet Knives. All right. This here, you guys, as you can see, it's part of their black class knives, which is really their tactical end. These are Benchmade ones, so this is the box. This is the little baggie it comes in, and the foam, and I don't know where the paperwork is, but I got that somewhere. But anyways, yeah, that's what the box looks like. It's 2551 BK. This is an automatic knife out the side. Just like so, and it's got the black coating, and it's got these aluminum handles, and it's got this special push button. I'm going to zoom in a little bit on this so you can see this. This is what the upgrade is from the original one. It's got this new enhanced push button, and it's got a larger spring. So if you look inside here, I'll see if I can, I don't know how well this will, yeah, you see that silver stuff in there? Won't really zoom in any more than that, but that's the spring. It's like a little coil spring right inside there, and that's what makes this have a lot of pop. So when you push this button, just like this, it pops right out. And the nice thing about this knife, as I've mentioned some of my other reviews, I'll get a link right up there to my original review on this, but the awesome thing about this knife is that it's got this thin profile blade, really thin profile. It's hard, you can't even really pick this up on the camera, but it's a really thin full flat grind. So what that allows you to do, being that it's so thin, is you can slice and cut stuff really easily. And it's got a nice point. It's really a drop point blade with a little bit of a, kind of like a clip. So a little bit of a drop and then an upward trend, but really nice feel to it. These have been one of the most popular ones because it's not a huge knife. It's just not a huge knife. Some of their other knives are really huge. They're heavy. This one's not like that. It's lightweight. It's just the right size. You still got a good almost 3 inches there of blade, and it cuts and cuts and cuts. It's a perfect slicer. It's a perfect, really, all around everyday carry. So a lot of military folks carry this knife. You also have a lock here. So if you have it in your pocket, you just push that forward, and that allows the pin not to move. You can see that right there. So it prevents that from moving. See, now that'll push in and open. But if you have that up like that, can't push. So guys, that's it. I mean, that's the sweet, sweet knife. And this one came really sharp from the factory. It's brand new, never been used, but we are going to sharpen it. So, I mean, what can I say? We're gonna sharpen this knife. We're gonna get it sharper. So this is the end of part one. If you like what you see so far, hit that like button and stay tuned. I'm gonna put this in the Wicked Edge. It doesn't matter what sharpener you got, but take your time, practice a lot with whatever sharpener you got, and then see how take your time. And that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go through it with the Wicked Edge. We're gonna get a mirror edge on it. So hang tight, guys. Thanks a lot. All right, YouTube, part two here. We're sharpening the Mini Reflex 2, the 2551 BK Benchmade. This is an awesome little military knife. We're going to get it nice and sharp, and it'll be so sharp, we won't know what to do. So I got it in the vise. I got a magic marker on. We got 200 grit here. We're going to just start out, see how this goes. You know, we shouldn't have to take off much material, so we'll just see. It's looking really good. I did line it up here just a minute ago, so it should definitely be good. Everything's looking good.
try this one again. This set.
Everything looks pretty good there. We're going to keep going. I'll probably start alternating here. Everything looks good so far. Maybe just a hair right there. If I can just see a little bit, just a teeny little bit on the end there. So I'm gonna just work that a little bit. Just real lightly. Careful not to roll it. That looks really good. All right, I think we're done with that step. Now we'll move on to 400 and 600. And we'll just keep plugging away. So I got the 400 diamonds here. And 400 diamonds here, and we'll just keep it going. Make sure everything looks good. I do that just to see if it catches. If your fingernail catches, you know it's sharp. And then that gives us a little bit of a baseline. It's just a simple way to see. I'm just looking there. Everything still looks real good. We'll just, I want to grind just a little bit more, real lightly. And I'll do that on this side. Kind of want to do the same thing on every side. So if you do a few on one side, do a few on the other. I think we're good. I think that's looking real good. So let's move on to 600. I just flipped these around. It's really easy. Now we're on 600.
I'll just do a nice little polish here. And I'll just keep going. Everything looks real good. So we'll just keep it going. About 50 more, 25 on each side here, and then we'll move on to 800 and 1,000. That feels really good. You can kind of tell once you get going, once you do this a little bit, it just starts feeling really good. And I'm getting that feeling that this one's feeling really good. So now we got 800. I find that most of my refinement and a lot that, it seems like a lot that happens in this 800 to 1,000. Now you have to do the right angle matchup and stuff like that around, you know, the lower grits. But it seems to me on the Wicked Edge, it seems like the 800 and the 1,000 are crucial steps. They're all crucial, but I don't know why. This just seems like it really takes it to the next level. Feels really good, guys. Okay, I'm using a different part of the cloth to clean so I don't contaminate. Let's move on to 1,000. I'll just do a light up and down here. I like just doing it like that, just so I can get the initial feel. Now we can wipe it real quick. You got to be really careful. It'll cut the hell out of you now. Well, it would have cut the hell out of you back around 200 too, but now it's just starting to get nutty.
All right.
Oh my God, that's really sharp. Holy shit. Okay, we're gonna move on to 1500. Here we come, 1500. I always like 1500 too, for some reason. It's just a good grit. Not much different than 1000, but it's just a little more refined. It almost sounds just like, well, you know. This one's going to be just, I don't know why. This one's really getting sharp. A little chamois there. Whew. That's, got to be careful. Okay, we'll do, 50 strokes like this and then move on. Felt amazing. I don't know. I'm getting some good vibes on this one. Not just saying that. Just it's really doing good. Okay, guys, 2200. 2200 grit diamonds. We'll do a little bit here and then. We'll go to the lapping films. Sorry about that. Go to 3000 on the other side. And I will wipe it again. I don't know, guys, it just feels very good. I'm gonna pause it for a sec. All right, I'm back. Someone came to my door. All right, now we're moving on to the lapping films. We're gonna start with, I'm gonna skip the 30 and just go straight to 12. We'll go to 12 micron lapping film and we'll just go like that. Well, what do you guys think? How does it look? We'll go to 9 micron now. 9 and 3. Here we go. Can you see a mirror now? Just those little bit of lapping films. It's just incredible. And by the way, guys, I sell these lapping films for Wicked Edge. I sell them for every system. So if you want these lapping films, that's this stuff. It's got the PSA adhesive, and it can stick to a glass plate or ceramic. Just shoot me a message right down below. I'll put the links in the description. But this stuff is just unbelievable. Look at that. I mean, it's just... I mean, it's... Well, you can see. I mean, look at that. I mean, it's incredible. Okay, we're going to move to 3. Here's 3 on the other side. And when I sell these, I sell 6 different ones all in one pack. So you got them all for one price. For every system, you just tell me what system you want, and I'll get them to you. This is the way to go, though. Like, if you really want the sharpest knife possible and you want that mirror edge, you gotta start using lapping films. I've used every other system, but nothing does as good. I don't know. You guys be the judge. I mean, what do you think? Sure looks like it's mirroring up good to me. Okay, here we go. 1 micron on the green side, the light green. And then on the white side, we got 60,000 grit, which is 0.3 micron. So that should do it, huh? This is kind of the finale. And I don't know why. That just, whenever I do that, it kind of, it's like it's so smooth. It just... I don't know. All right, enough of that. We're gonna clean it one last time, and then we're gonna do 1 micron here. That's it. This is the last stage. It's so sharp. It should almost be illegal to carry. Whoever gets this knife, they're going to have one sharp knife. Guys, that's it. I don't know if you can really even see that edge. It's so mirrored. But I'm going to take it out of the vise, and then I'll do a few close-ups, and then we'll call it a day. Thanks a lot. All right, YouTube, this video's taken me a while. I don't know why it's taken me so long, but this is the knife all done. You can look at that edge. It's immaculate. I don't know. It's hard. If you ever try to film a mirror and have it focus right, it just doesn't always want to focus right. But anyway, that's the knife. Perfectly done. I would say that's just really, really good. I'm going to just see if it can cut hairs on my arm. Running out of hairs here, but how about right in here? I mean... You saw that. This knife, you guys, is so sharp. It's, like I said earlier, it should probably be illegal. Anyways,
Hit that like button, guys. You know the drill. This is the kind of stuff you can do with these lapping films, the proper way of sharpening, and really just taking your time. It doesn't matter which system you used. I used a Wicked Edge this time, but you can get that edge on any system if you just take your time, practice, and don't go too fast. All right. Thanks a lot. Take care. Bye.